Morning. Oh, are you alright? My boy just stacked it. Do you need a cuddle? You're alright. Up you get. So, it's a standard. It's a Sunday morning and I am getting myself ready for the day. I wouldn't normally plan on a Sunday.
Let's go.
What, darling?
Let's go. It's a go.
Well, it was a ghost.
Go.
Where are we going? You want to go?
Go to a restaurant.
You want to go to a restaurant?
Yeah.
What, right now, on a Sunday morning at 7:30?
A restaurant.
A restaurant. What would you have at the restaurant?
I want a shop.
Okay, well, what we're doing first of all is we're actually planning the day because Mummy's not always that good with time, is she? So sometimes this morning we want to get loads of stuff done because we've got to go to Dylan's birthday party and Mummy's got to do some work and I need to exercise. So what I do is I just write down of my desires and intentions. Come where?
We're going to Dylan's birthday game.
Yeah, we're going to go to Dylan's birthday. Yes, I'm coming. I'm coming too.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you, Mummy.
See, this is why I have to plan my time and my day because I do not get a moment of just thinking.
Mummy, it's Mummy.
That's your bag, babe. Yeah, that's your bag. To just clear my mind and to think. Anyone else who lives with a two-year-old will know. So what I do is I start the day with just writing down what are my desires and intentions. I didn't get to exercise yesterday. My day kind of just floated away, which isn't a bad thing. It's not a bad thing to go with the flow from time to time. But at the same time, if you know you want to accomplish certain things in the day, get them out of your head and onto paper, because sometimes they can just be filling up space, going around and round, and you're never actually getting off at any of those stops to get that thing done. The other thing is, if you're not great with time, I'm an organized person, but I feel like maybe I'm time dyslexic. Is that a thing? I always get times wrong. I always get times back to front and find myself not necessarily being late, but just getting the amount of time that I have available wrong. I always think I've got a bit more time than I actually do. So I get everything down. Now, I believe that we don't want to be living off. Oh, baby. Oh, sweetie. He just hit his hand on the table. Oh, it's because you went to hit me and you hit the table. Sweetie, do you want me to kiss it? Well, what do we learn there? Don't hit Mummy. Is it the side of your finger?
No.
Oh, on your hand. And you know why it hurt a bit more? Because your fingers are so cold. Well, you get some clothes on. You want to need another cuddle? I think you're all right now.
No, I...
You're not all right now.
No.
Okay. But remember, we're going to Dylan's party and there's going to be cake.
Cake?
Yes, cake. So we don't want to be living off a to-do list. Nah, that's not great, because then you're always going to add something.
Is that purple?
It's blue. Well, it's kind of bluey purple. You're always going to be adding something and you're going to never feel like you're accomplishing. But I know that I've got a couple of hours. The dog is starting now. Where's your toy? Get your toy, Roxy. Where's your toy? Right, I think Roxy needs to go to the toilet. Honestly, she wanted to come up, so I had to swap them over. We don't want to be living off a to-do list, do we? The best way to work with a to-do list is to take the intentions, the desires that you have for the day, look at the amount of time that you've got, and then map those to-dos into the time, knowing how long each thing is going to take you. That way, you will know whether you've got enough time to fit them all in, or you can make sure that you adjust your time properly. It always feels good to scrub off that thing that you've done So don't live off one massive to-do list. Just think, what do you want to accomplish today? The things today. Not one long, big to-do list that you're always living by, because it's never going to disappear.